The CTAX limit instruction ramps up to speed and waits until it hits a limit where it ramps back down. It can also go back and find that limit or continue on to find a second limit at a creep frequency. For example, we have a proximity sensor mounted on the side over here, and it detects this paperclip when it passes by. The prox sensor is an MPN and is connected to the C302 channel 1 input C right here. Check out the hardware video for a parts list and wiring diagram of this system. To do this, we need to modify the module configuration. We go to our module configuration, select our module. We only have one in the rack. Let's give it a name. And configure the I/O. Over here are my outputs. I want to dedicate 0 and 1 to driving the stepper motor via pulse step and direction. That'll take up these two outputs. Once I've selected that, over here I get the option of putting a limit on that. So I'm going to use input channel 1C as the limit on out 0. I also could have used D for that. Notice that if I had defined these other channels, let's say this one, I could have put a limit on out 2. We don't need to do that, so we'll get rid of it. Hit OK, OK, and OK, and now our hardware is set up. We'll use the same CTX config that we used in the previous examples. Make sure we have our module selected. We do. And all the same parameters apply. Let's bring up the CTX limit instruction. CT axis limit. In this instruction, we want our device, this demo out, we want the limit to trip on the channel that we wired and set up in that system hardware configuration dialog a second ago. So we choose channel 1C. And we want it to trip on the rising edge of that signal. After the carriage is finished ramping down, we're going to have it return to that limit by specifying a zero offset here. We'll leave everything else the same, so we'll say OK. And we need to wire up the inputs for this. So let's enable this guy with X7. We'll have the direction be controlled by X6, and suspend will be X5. Accept, save it, write it to the PLC, and we're ready to go. If I reach down and flip X7 to enable this function, sure enough the carriage ramps up, travels down the guide, finds the limit switch, and backs up to it. And that's all there is to using motion with a limit. If you go back into this dialog, notice that instead of going back to the original position, we could actually tell it to go to a second limit switch if we wanted to. It would hit the first limit switch, ramp down, and then creep at whatever frequency you specify here until it finds the second limit switch. You could also click on reverse at limit 1. So limit 1 will complete, it'll ramp down, reverse the direction, and you could actually have it return back to limit 1 using this function, which is the exact same thing as this one, except now you get to specify the creep frequency. Well, that's all there is to implementing motion using the limit instruction. Be sure to check out the other videos in this series for more on using motion. And as always, please send us any comments you may have. We appreciate the feedback. Spend less, do more from Automation Direct.